Okay, YouTube, I'm here with Robert today. I met him in a gym. Robert says he's been here for a year, and he teaches in Thailand. Robert, you say you teach
elementary.
Yeah. Now, can I ask you a question? Why Thailand? Like, why did you decide to come here?
Experience. It's an exciting place. So, exciting place to be. You know, the travel. You've got so many places you can go to from Thailand. So. You've got places to be able to go to, you've got all of Asia, Australia, it's easy to get to from Bangkok.
Now, were you one of those types who just wanted to travel and see the world and you just ended up in Thailand, or?
When I was teaching in England, it was always one of the things I wanted to go and work somewhere abroad.
Yeah.
But I didn't know where. And just looking on the internet for jobs, and I looked at Asia, looked at the US, and I came across Bangkok and applied for it and got the job.
Now, the people think that when you come to other countries like this, the pay isn't so good. I mean, are they paying you on the England scale? They're paying you mostly on the Bangkok scale?
I actually, coming out here, I think I got, I'm trying to think what it is in US dollars, but I mean, I got equivalent to about £200 or £300 extra a month than what they paid me in England.
Really?
Yeah. So what about $400 or $500 extra a month?
Okay.
Being here, because you get there's my basic salary, but then I have I get housing allowance, I get after school club allowance, I got my flight paid for coming out here, my visas all paid for. So yeah, it worked out quite well.
Now, the gym that I'm at, I mean, we paid the weekly rate, which is more than I would pay in the U.S. So I take it this is pretty upper-level type gym. As far
yeah,
as
I mean, there's not many gyms in Bangkok at the moment. I pay for a full-year membership, and it works out a little bit more than what I pay back home.
Yeah.
But then I get paid more here, and it's cheaper to live here, so it works out.
So you get paid more in Bangkok and you will get paid back home.
Home.
That's amazing. So I'm sure living here with that type of salary is pretty good. Are you considered the upper class, middle class?
I mean, the thing is with Bangkok, you have upper class, and then you have low. There's a big gap between the rich and the poor.
Really?
But I definitely say I'm probably one of the higher earners. Yeah.
Wow.
Yeah.
So how long do you see yourself living here, Rob?
Well, unfortunately, I've only got a couple more months because I have a fiance back in England.
Oh.
Who I have to go back to. She's been coming out quite a lot. But I think maybe in the future, maybe trying to find her some work here and maybe coming back out again.
So that living in Bangkok basically is a better experience, would you say, than England?
Cost of living straight ahead is just, I mean, I rent a condo in pretty much the city center of Bangkok, and it probably is, I mean, it's 18,000 baht a month, which is, I mean, probably, let me work this out, maybe five times cheaper, maybe more than that, five, six times cheaper than what it costs to rent. No, more than that, maybe about seven or eight times cheaper than what it costs to rent a flat in London. Yeah.
Now that sounds around about $600 US a month, somewhere close to around there.
Maybe a little less than that. Maybe.
And is that upscale?
Yeah, I mean, it's not the biggest condo that I could afford more.
Yeah.
But I'd rather pay less. It's only a single one bedroom condo. I could afford more, but I don't need a bigger place, you know.
So you're definitely saving money over here.
Oh, if I wanted to, I mean, I'm putting away maybe about 15,000 to 20,000 baht a month, but I could probably put away a lot more if I wanted to. If I tried.
Wow.
That's 15,000 to 20,000 without trying.
Now, do you speak the language here?
A little bit. I don't know.
Sawatdee krap. A little bit more than that.
Yeah, you don't really need to speak the language, but it definitely helps to know a little bit. Taxi drivers don't really speak any English here.
Yeah.
Street food sellers don't speak any English. I mean, I think Thailand is supposed to be, in all of Asia, one of the least developed in terms of their English speaking.
Really?
From what I've heard, yeah.
Okay.
They're quite far behind. That's why they have so many people coming over here to teach English, because they're so behind the rest of Asia.
So there is a good opportunity for people who want to...
If you wanted to come out here, and it depends what you're doing. I mean, if you have a degree, like from university, you can come out here and you can teach English. The pay is pretty good, but if you are a qualified teacher in your own country, so in the US or England or wherever, and then you come out here, then you can earn some big money.
I mean, now, just curious, just basic starting out as a teacher in Bangkok.
As a qualified or non-qualified?
Qualified.
As a qualified, a US qualified teacher coming out here, depending on what school, with all the other packages, probably about 80-90,000 baht a month.
80-90,000?
Yeah, 80-90,000 baht a month. And then depending on what school you go to, you can earn up to 150,000 baht a month, depending on what school you go.
150,000
baht a month.
So right around, that sounds about anywhere from 2,500 to 3,000 a month for an American.
Yeah.
And then depending on the school,
depending on
a lot more. Wow, that's pretty good.
Mm. The school I work at, we have people from the UK, we have people from the US, we have people from Canada, from Australia, from New Zealand.
Wow.
All working out.
Okay. So one last question. The protests are going on right now. Before I came here, a lot of people from America was like, don't go over there, it's too dangerous, you know? Has the protest affected you any since you've been?
Well, I was supposed to be in work today, but
really?
They closed the school. We had to leave. We left school earlier yesterday because a bomb went off.
I heard about that.
Around not too far from our school. I don't think it's too bad. I mean, I don't know, it might get a little bit worse, but I think it's one of these things. During the daytime, it's got a bit of a carnival atmosphere to it.
Yeah, I heard the music coming in.
Yeah, in the evening, at night time, middle of the night, it's when things can get a bit, you know, a bit more violent. I just think, as long as you're sensible, I don't go out so late at the moment, as I would normally, maybe at the weekend, because, you know, there have been things happening. But I think as long as you make an effort to stay away from it, you know, especially at night, it's fine. You know, they're not wanting to cause any problems for tourists or expats.
Yes. It's
an issue between, you know, them and the government. You know, so they don't really want to cause as much impact as the Westerners.
And one last thing, for someone thinking of coming to Thailand to teach English, to do anything, what would your advice be to them?
Do your research before coming to Thailand. There's a lot of little things that you have to do a bit of research on, just about the way of life. Just little things that I think some tourists come here quite ignorant of it. And I think it's just good to do your research on do's and don'ts in Thailand, I think.
Cool.
There's a lot of places to find it out and just go and have a look. Yeah.
Well, thanks a lot, Robert, for your time. I know we just met and just kind of bombarded you with the camera and said, hey, Rob, want to do an interview? But I hope your stay here will be good, and good luck on your marriage with your fiance.
You.
And hopefully you can get her back to Thailand.
Thank you.
Cheers.